Hello kids, welcome to 10Learn. Today we will do book exercise and question answers of
Chapter 3, Fiber to Fabric of Science Class 6.
First of all, we will do fill in the blanks. First, dash are thin strands of thread that are twisted together to make yarns. Fibers are thin strands of threads that are twisted together to make yarns. Second, dash involves arranging two sets of yarns to make fabric. Weaving involves arranging two sets of yarns to make fabric. Third, cotton, wool and silk are dash fibers. Cotton, wool and silk are natural fibers. Fourth, dash is obtained from outer covering of husk of coconut. Coir is obtained from the outer covering of husk of the coconut. Fifth, fiber obtained from flax plant are used to make dash. Fiber obtained from the flax plant are used to make linen. Next is choose the correct options. Which of these involves making fabric from a series of connected loops of yarn? Answer is knitting. Second, which of these is not true for jute plant? We get jute from bark of the flax plant. It grows best in loamy soil. Jute fibers are separated by rotting of stem. The process is called retting. Or D, none of these. Answer is, we get jute from bark of the flax plant. Third is, which of these fibers would you use to make a pair of denim jeans? A. Cotton, B. Coir, C. Hemp, D. Jute. A. Cotton. Fourth, which of these involves a loom? Retting, weaving, spinning or knitting? Answer is, third, weaving. Fifth, which of these are obtained from the fruit of kapok trees? Jute, hemp, flax or silk cotton? Answer is D, silk cotton. Next is very short answer type questions. A. Give one word for the following. First, the material made by weaving or knitting of yarn. Answer, fabric. Second, the pattern in which two sets of threads are arranged in a cloth. Weaving. Third, fibers that are made by man from chemical substances, synthetic fibers. Fourth, the small green fruit of cotton plant, cotton ball. Fifth, the process of making yarn from fibers, spinning. B. Give two examples for each of the following. First, natural fibers, cotton and jute. Second, products made from jute fiber, jute bag and mat. Third, products made from silk cotton, life jackets and sleeping bags. Fourth, products made from flax fiber, ropes and high quality paper. Now we will do short answer type questions. What are clothes made of? Clothes are made of fabric, which are made from fibers. Fiber are thin strands of threads that are twisted to form yarn. Yarns are woven or knitted to form fabric, for example, cotton fabric and silk fabric. Question 2. What are synthetic fibers? Give two examples. Fibers that are made by man from chemical substances are called synthetic fiber, for example, nylon, rayon, polyester, and acrylic. Third, what is ginning? The process of separating cotton fiber from its seed is called ginning. Fourth, describe the process of retting. The process of rotting the stem of the plant in water to remove the sticky substance and separate the fiber is called retting. Question 5. Name the three products made from jute fiber. Jute fiber are used to make jute bags, hats and mats. Now we will do long answer type questions. Question 1. What are fibers? How do we get cloth from fibers? Answer is, fibers are thin strands of threads that are twisted together to make yarn. Yarns are woven or knitted to form fabric. For example, cotton fabric and silk fabric. The fabric is stitched to make clothes. For example, cotton fabric can be stitched into a cotton frock or a kurta. There are two main processes of making fabric from yarns, weaving and knitting. The process shows these steps: fiber twisted to make yarn, knitted or woven to make fabric, and fabric is stitched to make clothes. Now we'll do question 2. Describe two processes of making fabric from yarn. Answer. The two main processes for making fabric from yarn are weaving and knitting. Weaving is a method of textile production in which two distinct sets of yarns or threads are interlaced at right angles to form a fabric or cloth. It is done using a machine called loom that can be hand operated or power operated. The pattern in which two sets of threads are arranged in a piece of woven cloth is called a weave. Knitting. The process of getting a single yarn together by forming a series of connected loops of yarn to form a fabric is called knitting. It is mostly used for woolen wears. This is done manually using knitting needles or sometimes using machines. Sweaters are made from woolen yarns by knitting. Question 3. Describe the steps involved in production of cotton. Answer. Cotton fiber comes from cotton plant grown in fields by farmers. The cotton crop is usually grown in the places that have black soil and a warm climate. Cotton fiber grows in the seed pod or ball of the cotton plant. The cotton balls are of size of lemons. After maturing, the cotton balls burst and open to produce cotton seeds covered with white soft cotton fiber. Each fiber is a single elongated cell that is flat, twisted, and ribbon-like with a wide inner hollow. The heat of the sun dries the fiber. After the fiber have dried, the cotton fiber picked up from the field, usually by hand, has cotton seeds in them. The raw fiber are separated from these seeds by the process of ginning. Cotton is used to make clothes and other products such as towels, carpet, sheets, etc. Clothes made out of cotton are light and comfortable. Question 4. Describe how jute fiber is obtained from the plant. Answer. Jute fiber is obtained from the stem of the jute plant. Jute fiber are naturally glued together by a sticky or gummy substance. This sticky substance needs to be removed in order to obtain the fibers. The fiber is extracted from the stem of the jute plant by the process of retting. Thus, the jute plant are cut from the fields when they are in the flowering stage. The stem of the harvested jute plant are immersed in clean pond water or slow-running stream for a few days to clean and soften the fibers and to facilitate its stripping from the stem. During this time, the stems rot and the fiber are left behind. After a while, the fiber are separated from water by hand. This process of rotting the stem of the plant in water and removing the sticky substance and separate the fiber is known as retting. Jute is a rough fiber and is not used for making fabrics or clothes for dresses, but it is a strong plant fiber and is therefore used for making ropes and jute or gunny bags. Question 5. Write short notes on the following. First, coir fiber. Coir is a natural fiber that is obtained from the outer covering of the husk of the coconut. There are two types of coir: brown fiber, which is obtained from the mature coconut, and the finer white fiber, which is extracted from the immature green coconut after soaking them for up to 10 months. Typically, white coir spun into yarn is used in the manufacture of rope and finishing net owing to its strong resistance to salt water. Brown coir is stronger and more widely used than white coir. Applications include sack, brushes, doormats, rugs, mattresses, insulation, panels, and packaging. Second is silk cotton fiber. Silk cotton fiber is a silky fluffy fiber obtained from the fruit of silk cotton tree, also called as tapa. It is commonly used for stuffing cushions and mattresses and for other purposes that requires a soft voluminous filling. Third is hemp fiber. Hemp fiber is obtained from the stem of hemp plant. It is used to make ropes, carpets, twins, sailcloth, sacks, bags, and webbing. The waste and woody fiber of the stem are sometimes used to make paper. The finer grades can be woven into a type of cloth that resembles coarse linen. Last is flax fiber. Flax fiber, linen or flax fabric is obtained from the stem of flax plant. Linen fabric is highly moisture absorbent and durable. It freezes easily and requires ironing. However, it is stiffer than cotton. Linen is usually used in the manufacture of summer clothes and home linen. So that was all about question answers of this chapter. Thanks for watching and see you soon in next video.